Can you mentally find out, and the emphasis is on the word mentally, what is 102 times 103 in 3 seconds? So your time starts now. The time is up. The correct answer would be 10506. Yeah, there it is. 10506. Now, to multiply 102 with 103, all you need to do is add this 3 to this entire number. So, 102 plus 3 is 105. Now, two more digits to go. So, 2, 3 times is 6. So, put 06 here. I'm sure this time you have figured out what I have done, isn't it? Again, I have used the same base method of multiplication. I have used the base as 100. Right. So, 103 is 3 more than the 100. So, add this extra 3 to this entire number. So, we'll get the first 3 digits of your answer. Alright. Now, since 100 has 2 zeros, so there are 2 more places to go. So, for that, just simply multiply this number with this number. 2, 3 times is 6. Okay. So, since there is one empty space here, what do? Put some extra cheese in it. Alright. Yeah. So, just put 0 there. That's it. And I am explaining it to you, so I have to put down everything, but you need not do all that thing, isn't it? You are just seeing these numbers. Can't you say that the answer would be 10506? Isn't it? Just in your mind, add this 3 to 102, which is not a very difficult thing to do. So you'll get the first 3 digits, 105. Now for the last 2 digits, all you need to do is multiply this 2 with 3. So put 06 there. As simple as that. Okay, so now you find out and mentally what is 105 times 102? Have you said the answer? Right. Whatever you said is absolutely correct. The answer is 10710. Isn't it? Add this 2 to 105, so it is 107. Two more digits to go because base 100 has 2 zeros. So just multiply this number with this number. 5, 2 times is 10. So, 10710. Come on. You're multiplying a 3-digit number with another 3-digit number mentally in 2 or 3 seconds. What more do you want? Perhaps multiply a 4-digit number with another 4-digit number in 1 second? Yeah, and that is what we are about to do. Okay, so keep your fingers crossed. What is 133 times 103? Again, the same thing. Add this 3 to 133. So, 136. Now, 2 more digits to go. Alright. Now, 33 3 times. So, multiply it with 3 from left to right. So, 3 3 times is 9 and 3 3 times is 9. So, the answer is 136 9 9. Now, try to multiply 162 with 134. Now, as you can see that 134 is at the distance of 34 from 100. So, add this 34 to 162. Alright. So, it would be 166, 176, 186, 196. Okay. Using the jumping 10 trick of addition. Alright. Now, two more digits to go here. Right. So, for that, you have to multiply 62 with 34. How do you do that? Using the one-step arrow multiplication. So, 6 3 times is 18. And 6 4 times is 24 and 3 2 times is 6 and 24 plus 6 is 30 and 2 4 times is 8. So 18 plus 3 is 21, 0 8. So you write 21 here and 0 8 here. So the answer would be 19 plus 2 is 21 and 7, 0 8. That is what your answer is. You see how beautifully these easy calc tricks integrate with each other. Isn't it? That is the beauty of it all. One trick seamlessly merging with the other trick. Okay, now let's see if you can multiply 1006 with 1003. Now you are trying to multiply 2 4-digit numbers, alright? And you'll see that it is as easy as multiplying a single-digit number. Alright, so again, same thing. Add this 3 to this entire number. So it would be 1009. Now, what you must have observed is that the base here is 1000, isn't it? 1000 has 3 zeros, so 3 more places to go. Alright, so 6 3 times is 18, so we write 018. That's our answer. See? It's huge. Right.